If electric cars are the future, then luxury electric cars are the future of luxury, right? Hey, what is up, guys? I'm KBHD here, and I spent a day with a completely unreleased future electric car called the Lucid Air and the team behind it to take the closest look at it yet and just to learn what the deal is with this car and the future of electric cars. And I learned a lot. Now, we're already familiar with Tesla and what they make and how that works. You can check out my videos about them if you haven't already. Lucid Air claims to be, in a lot of ways, kind of similar to that, but with a few tricks up its sleeve. So the exterior is pretty familiar, all the way from the miniature size mock-ups, all the way to the life-size one-to-one clay models they showed me. It has its own unique look, you could say. It's not a hatchback, so it looks a lot more like a big sedan than a crossover. And they do their best to look a little more modern, nothing too extreme, but it's a little sleeker. The mirrors on the sides are a little smaller, a little sleeker looking. The low profile wheels kind of remind me of the BMW i8. The door handles are completely embedded in the doors with push to unlock, and there's extra lights around here and there, even bar headlights and tail lights. One of the most eye-catching features actually from the promo video, those headlights,
groundbreaking technology,
were actually not motorized in the prototype that we got to use, which made me sad. Basically, I can only cross my fingers that, who knows, maybe it'll actually make it to the final version. But the exterior, as clean as it is definitely not the reason people are interested in the Lucid Air. That would be the interior. One of the biggest complaints with Tesla actually is the interior just doesn't feel luxury enough for some people. I mean, it was never a problem for me, but the other people coming from, you know, BMWs and high-end Mercedes and Porsches were actually kind of disappointed with the interior of the Tesla and pointed at that as being one of the biggest flaws for the price. Lucid Air is really attacking that luxury feel, 100%. They're going all out with material choices, the layout of the displays, the look and feel of everything to overall make the experience of sitting in the car, especially in the back seat, as dope as possible. So first of all, inside as the driver up front, naturally you have a lot of control at your fingertips. So as soon as you sit in the driver's seat, you have three displays surrounding you, a touchscreen all the way up to the left with a bunch of vehicle controls, the heads-up display right behind the steering wheel with the most important information like your speed and the battery percentage, or maybe possibly the most beautiful charging indicator status I've ever seen. And then another touchscreen to the right of that with smart systems, things like navigation and contacts, etc. It kind of makes sense that a high-tech vehicle from the future has this many pixels laid out in front of you, but they seem smartly laid out and they have the features that are sort of complementing each other in the right spots in the car. And then on top of all of that, there's another touchscreen, a center console, where you can display navigation info and third-party apps and all kinds of stuff like that. But it's a little down and out of the way, so you can hide it at any time with a push of a button that actually reveals more center storage. So it seems to be a pretty solid balance between physical controls and touchscreen controls for things that you do with the vehicle every day from the front seat. And then the second thing you'll notice as a driver, or anyone in the front seat, is the windshield. It is awesome. It reminds me of what Tesla did with the Model X. The glass stretches basically from the hood right up all the way over your head to behind you. So it's just one big pane of glass. There's just light flooding in and you can see everything. It's kind of how the Lucid Air got its name. It creates a very open, airy experience where you can see all around you. And I guarantee that when this car is driving itself in a couple of years, it'll be that much cooler just looking around. It'll be a lot of fun to be a passenger. But there are some differences between this and the Model X. First off is that T column down the middle that you can see that holds an LED light strip. It's the ambient light and the rear view mirror and the sunshades. And a second thing, a switch for the electrochromic shading that will tint the ceiling from nearly transparent all the way to almost completely opaque. Now, unfortunately, this is also still in development and they couldn't show it to me working, but it seems to me that that would be really cool and also really expensive if you ever got a crack in your windshield. But either way, it's awesome to be able to look up at any time. And the way it is transparent, you can see, you know, not just the clouds, but even skyscrapers when you're going through the city or the stars at night since it's completely clear. Really cool stuff to be sitting in the front seat of this car. And then you get to the back seat, and that is where it gets real. The back seat of the Lucid Air is these jet-like bucket seats with tons of legroom and headroom. With all that glass over your head still, it just keeps sweeping back. And the premium materials and the armrest and vents are all still there. You even get your own little console in the middle with climate control and seat recline controls. And on top of that, this isn't just your average seat back recline. This is like, you're not gonna wanna call shotgun in this car. You're gonna want to sit in the back seat. These back seats recline way back, so far back, it kind of feels like a lie flat on an airplane. When you're all the way back, you're just kind of looking up at a clear pane of glass. So you can sit back and basically just stare at the sky for a long car ride as a passenger. That definitely feels like the future. The biggest sacrifice for the seats this far back is definitely the trunk space. For the size of the car and all its advantages, it maybe has one of the smaller trunks I've ever seen in a large sedan, but Lucid also does have a regular bench back seat version of this car that feels a little less luxury, but gets a lot of the trunk space back. So, you know, a little bit of a fair trade there. That'll probably sell a lot more in the US, and there's also a sizable front trunk in this car that's a lot bigger actually than the one that's in the Tesla as well. So there's a lot of cool stuff going on for the Lucid Air as an idea and as a product. The fact that this company, Lucid Motors, exists and is making a statement, like trying to make a product like this, is really interesting to me. Whether it actually comes out or not, it sheds a lot of light on what it looks like people are going to want from a car in the future, which doesn't just have to be a good driving car, but also has to be a good ride-sharing car and a good self-driving car, etc. So it's silent, huge, spacious, open, airy, high-tech, and oh, by the way, happens to have 1,000 horsepower and ridiculous performance, because electric cars can do that. Nice. So what do you think? Is this the future of luxury? I know I'm not against it, and I'm definitely rooting for companies like this to succeed to be able to provide competition and make what we already have get better. So let me know what you guys think of the Air. Thanks for watching this one, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Peace.